So hi guys, I'm Priyanka and you are watching Organizopedia. So today I'm very happy because I'm doing a video which is requested by so many of you friends, and that is on kitchen organization. As we all know, kitchen is one such place where we spend so much of time and we always keep looking for ideas to make one thing or the other better in our kitchen. So let's get on to the business right away. Brought here a plan to do a kitchen organization series, and I'm going to divide the series in different parts. Like in one, I'm going to show you how you can organize your countertop. In one, I'll show you how to organize your undersinks, some cleaning hacks related to kitchen and other organization systems which you can adapt to make your kitchen quite workable for you. And in this way, I'll cover each and every aspect related to kitchen, and that would be quite easy for you guys also. Today it's part 1 and I'm going to focus on undersink area, which I believe is the most vulnerable space in the kitchen. And you always seem to run out of ideas when it comes to properly organizing and to keep the space clean. And before I proceed, I want to mention that today's video will help you even if you don't have modular kitchens. So without any further ado, let's get into the video.
So this is how my undersink area look like. As you can see, I kept very few things which I use on daily basis, and frankly speaking, I don't have any idea how to properly organize this space. So this is how it looks. Then I motivated myself to change this area and to do something better with it. Now as you can see, I lay the surface with the help of this fiber sheet, which you can find it in any hardware shop. I got it cut from the shop itself. So earlier I was not able to clean the surface properly, but with the help of the sheet, you can take the sheet out, clean it, and then you can put it back. And as you can see, I cut a small circle on the sheet so that my drainage pipe will go inside and there will be very less space for insects. So this is basically DIY locker stand. And if you want to know how to make it, just comment down below and I'll give you a whole video how to make it. I make it with the help of PVC pipes. So if you don't have a huge space for keeping your things, so this is the ideal way of keeping your things above and under the table. So as you can see, I kept it in one of the corners and I'm just putting this tray. I'm going to utilize both the area above the tray and under the tray. So this is one of the baskets. As you can see, I wrote stainless steel scrubber, and in this I'm keeping all my new scrubbers, and I'm going to put it just under that table. So as you can see, I'm utilizing the vertical space quite well here. And in this basket, I'm keeping all my drain cleaner sachet. I wrote drain cleaner, and I'm going to keep this basket just next to the scrubbers basket. Then I took this basket, and in this I'm going to keep all my scrubbers, my scotch bite scrubbers. Every scrubbers goes into this basket and I'm keeping it in here. So this is how I organized this area below the locker stand, and I used it quite efficiently. So this was the thing which I was earlier trying to explain you, that if you don't have huge space, you can stack your things up and down and you can put so many things in this small area. So above the tray, I'm keeping all my new stuff and all, like Colin, glass cleaner, Morton, DIY tap cleaners, etc. Very easily you can find these locker stand online, but when you compare the prices, this is very cost effective. So here it's a plastic bowl. In this I'm keeping all the extra spoons which you get when you buy ice cream, Cerelac, etc. So I'm keeping it on the locker stand. This is basically the spare spoons. If sometime I just ran out of spoons in my washing powder box, so I just take the spoon from here and then keep it down in my box. So next comes this basket. As you can see, this basket has got lid, so I'm keeping all my fresh new kitchen towels in this because it has lid. So I take my towel, I fold it, and then I roll it up. So like this, I just keep it, I cover the box, and then I'm going to keep it in just the right corner of my undersink. So as this is the box which I'm not going to use it on daily basis, so I'm just putting it in here. So next, this is the green basket, and in this I'm going to arrange all my new stuff, which is like my dishwash powder, liquid dishwash cleaner, some cakes. And I'm going to put this basket just above my basket of kitchen towels. So as you can see, here I keep it. So I stack it one over other. So here comes again the green basket, and I'm going to keep things in this basket, which I'm not going to use it on daily basis. That is why I'm keeping it just behind my drainage pipes. So in this, I'm going to keep my extra and new floor cleaners, and I stack them one over other. So in same basket, I'm going to keep these new sponge wipes and my new kitchen gloves. So all these are the things which I'm keeping it in this basket. As I told earlier that I'm not going to use these things on daily basis. So I think it's okay that I'm keeping them behind the drainage pipes. So as you can see, I labeled this basket as cleaning brushes. In this, I'm keeping all my new kitchen brushes, soap brush, toothpaste, and a spoon which was not fitting there, so I kept it here. Then I'm going to keep it in this space. So this is a square glass jar, and I labeled it orphan socks. I keep all my like extra socks in here for kitchen cleaning purpose. And this box has got lid, so I just cover this box, and I'm going to keep it just over there. So here it goes. So as I labeled it cleaning brushes, so these are not my new brushes. These are the brushes which I'm using on my daily basis to clean my kitchen, under sink, sink and everything. So I'm just putting all my regular brushes in here. And then here it goes, I kept it here. So now let's move on to these cabinets door. I have this hanging basket attached to my door. So in this particular space, I keep all the things which I am going to use it on daily basis, like dishwash powder, liquid soap, soap cleaner, etc. So now let's talk about this particular basket. And in this basket, I'm keeping some stuff like brass cleaner, which I'm keeping in these plastic boxes. Up next comes the baking soda. And this is the most favorite thing of mine. Next, I'm keeping this glass cleaner, which I'm keeping just behind the brass cleaner box. Then here comes this disinfectant, which I'm keeping it in kitchen only because I wash my baby's toys, feeding spoons and etc. And then this is the liquid brass cleaner. So I'm just keeping it behind these boxes. So this is how this basket look like. So now let's talk about this particular basket, which is given to keep the dustbin. But I am keeping all the new stuff, so I'm not going to keep dustbin in here. So I took this plastic basket, which as you can see fit in properly, and in this I keep all my new garbage bags. So this is how the whole under sink area look like, and I am very happy that I finally managed to organize my under sink area. So I hope I have given you an idea that how to organize all these stuff in such a small space. So earlier I used to keep all these new stuff in one of my cabinet drawer, but finally I have got a room to keep all these new stuff, and that is under the sink only. So it's basically the extension of the first idea. These are the hooks which you get from hardware shop. Just mark a point on one of the side walls, nail it. Get this PVC pipe from again the hardware shop, like this, just insert it, insert the other end, and then with the help of this T hook you just fix it. Please don't mind, I'm using this newspaper just to show you guys, and this is how it looks. Then I fix it with the help of adhesive, and as you can see, I hang my daily kitchen gloves, my cleaning clothes, etc. So this is how I use this PVC pipe to hang all these things. As I said, this video will help you even if you don't have modular kitchen. So you don't get these kind of doors if you don't have like modular kitchen. So here, now let's organize this under sink again when you don't have these small baskets. So as you can see, I kept this garbage bag basket here in this corner. Then I took this basket, and in this basket I'm going to arrange all the things which I was earlier keeping it on my baskets which I got on my door. So here, as you can see, I have arranged all the things. I'm going to keep this basket here on the left of my under sink. Then you can arrange your cleaning brush, new cleaning brush, extra stuff the way you want to. So in this third way, I have tried to give you an idea. If you don't have modular kitchen, then also you can organize your undersink area quite well. Earlier, I was not able to put these things in here because I have got these baskets on my door. So as you can see, I was not able to close them properly if I arrange all the stuff here. So if you don't have these doors, you can definitely arrange your stuff in here. And if you want, you can even keep a dustbin because this area would be open. So it would be quite easy for you to clean this space. So now let's talk about the fourth and the final way. Like earlier, I used this PVC rod to keep my gloves and cleaning clothes. So along with it, you can keep your spray bottles also in here. And as you can see, by doing so, I get some extra space on that locker stand. So you can put your extra stuff there which you don't use on daily basis, or rearrange the stuff the way you want to. So finally, this is how the whole undersink area look like. If you don't have a modular kitchen, you can adapt this way.
So guys, as you saw, I mostly tried very frugal ideas so that you don't spend too much money in buying those different things. And I hope you like them, and if so, then you know what to do. Please do subscribe to my channel for more such future videos. Like the video,